just a couple little updates on the Jeep. It drives nice still, but what I'm noticing is the RPMs are almost too high for me to just be driving it every day. I feel like if I'm going, you know, up to Utah or something, it's going to be kind of a long highway ride, and the motor's going to be spinning pretty fast. But the NAG 1 has been very good. It shifts quickly, a little bit of throttle input. So it definitely shifts good, you know. If I was lower RPMs, then I wouldn't really be bothered by it as much. But I just think the 8-speed will help me get my highway gears lower, or my highway RPM lower, a lot lower. And then even that first gear ratio, that gear one gear ratio is really low. So that'll be nice. The transfer case I decided to go with is the non-Rubicon transfer case, the sport transfer case. It's a 272:1 gear ratio. That's going to be almost equivalent to what I'm running right now with the Rubicon case with the NAG 1 for my first gear low range. It'll be just about the same. The benefit will be I won't have to go in and out of low range as often, because I'll be able to actually go faster in low range with the 8-speed. Before, with the NAG 1 in the 513 gears, I was finding that I'd have to pull it out of low range if I was wanting to go over, you know, 15 miles per hour. So I'd always be stopping in the middle of the trail. But with the sport transfer case, it won't be having to pull it out as often. So I'll be able to stay in 4 low. And then, I think that'll be a good benefit. Also, they were a lot cheaper than the other Rubicon cases. The reason I couldn't use mine is because mine's an automatic 2013. But to attach to the 8-speed, you need to either use a 2007 to like 18 manual Jeep, or a 2007 to 11 automatic or manual Jeep transfer case. Those are the only ones that are compatible with the 8-speed. If you already have the NAG 1 and that's what you're planning on using, don't get me wrong, it shifts nice. Just got my HP70 in today. Let's take a look at it.
So one of the first things we need to do is get the valve body pulled out. That way we can pull the computer off of it, TCM. and I gotta send it into a Jeep's Beach Shop so they can flash it. When they flash it, it allows you to use the tap shifting, and they put a Challenger flash on this actual TCM. Just because this came out of a Dodge Ram, the tap shift won't work if we use the flash that's on this from the factory. So let's take it apart. All right, so what we gotta do is get this thing flipped over on its tail end. That way we can get that TCM taken out. Probably flip it over, turn its tail end, and flip it over once more. So let's see what we can do with this guy. Now that we got it flipped over on its face, on its top, now we can go through and remove the oil pan.
All right, next we need to go through and remove 13 of the oil pan bolts. This is a T40. This is so we can get to the inside of it and take the valve body out to get to the computer. So we'll go through and remove all these. Make sure you save them so you can reuse them. So the next step is take that T40 we still were using to take the oil pan off and take out the valve body bolts. I will post a picture of what bolts need to be removed. They're all going to be the same size. Next, you need to lift up this little tab here. Don't forget about this little bolt. That's another one that needs to come out. The bolts over here are the shorter ones. The bolts in here are the longer ones, but they're all the same Torx bit size. So now we should be ready to wiggle it out. Shouldn't really be too difficult to come out.
After you lift this guy up, you gotta get this plastic piece out.
That's for the actual plug.
All right, yep, gotta take this all the way out. It can get kind of stuck in there a little bit, but just gotta work it out slowly.
Like that, make sure no dirt gets inside of it. And then this should be ready to come on out. Just like that. Go ahead and set it down. All right, just like that, valve body's out. Next is the computer removal. All right, next we need to get a T27 and remove the bolts for the computer. I'll put a picture on there of what bolts need to be removed. All right, we took out the 2, 3, 4, 5 bolts that hold on the valve body. Next, we got to get this little plug unplug, so we'll turn the valve body over. All
All right, and it should just come right off. And just like that, you've got your TCM out. This is what gets sent to Jeep Speed Shop. Like that. I recommend putting the oil pan back on. Keep the insides of your transmission nice and clean.
All right, so while we wait for parts, we will take out the transmission, we will take out the exhaust, the drive shafts, which I've already done. So then we'll pull down the transmission and get ready to put the other one in. So we'll swap out parts, we'll get the transfer case ready, kind of just make sure everything's good to go. So we'll be doing that next. So I got the modified NAG one out of the Jeep. I mean modified because it's got the hemi housing, bell housing. Now I just need to take it apart, split the case from there. I'm gonna see if I can reuse my old shift bracket. I'm not sure if that'll work or not, but we will find out. And then I've got a non-Rubicon transfer case. I'll just, you know, swap out my yokes and see what I need to do to get it bolted up to the 10-8 speed over there. So, all right, let's get more work done. Get this transfer case set up. We'll change the yokes on it to the new non-Rubicon and get it ready to be bolted up to the 8-speed.
here we're gonna do a little bit of talking, a little bit of comparison, and explain a little bit of why you need to change your transfer cases and, you know, kind of the differences. So right here we have the Nag 1. That's out of my 2013 Wrangler. Changed the bell housing out, that way you could bolt right up to the Hemi. And then over here, flipped upside down just because I've got the valve body out. This is the 8-speed, the 8 HP70 out of a Dodge Ram. I'll list the years in the description of what you can use. If you look here at the output shaft, the tail shaft basically, this part is a male. The Nag 1 is a female. So then let's go over to the transfer cases. This was the original transfer case that came out of it, out of my 2013 Rubicon. You can see what comes out or goes into the transmission is a male on here. Just that would insert in that female. Now for the non-Rubicon, like the, or let's say manual transmissions from any year or 2007 to 11, manual or auto, the output, the input shaft under the transfer case is a female. And that allows it to attach to the 8-speed. So that's essentially why you need to switch. So if, let's say this Rubicon was a manual Rubicon, then it would have the correct output shaft or the input shaft on the transfer case. But because it didn't, I had to change transfer cases. And then I decided to go with a non-Rubicon transfer case. So the torque converters from the Nag 1, it's got the, it's bigger here, meaning that when it goes up to the actual flex plate or the crank, it should fit the same as the 8-speed. Where I believe if you have a different type of transmission, you're gonna need that bushing to adapt to make it fit. But this one should be all set up coming from a Nag 1. The other thing is if you look, they're pretty lined up on the front. They are not much of a difference for length. You know, I don't think I'm gonna have to change my, do anything with my drive shafts. I got aftermarket drive shafts, but I mean, maybe it's a half an inch longer. You know, just eyeballing it. The other thing that I was wondering is, am I gonna be able to use this intermediate plate from the Nag 1? And it looks like the whole top part of the motor, because this is the top here, because I have flipped over, that all bolts up. But where it doesn't is where it comes to the bottom of the transmission. The holes don't line up. That also means that the structural brace is not the correct one. So I'm gonna have to get a different structural brace and a different intermediate plate. So now we need to prepare the inside for all the electronics and then the shifter. So to remove the center console, there's a couple things we have to do. First, you have to really struggle to pull this guy off. Two hands on it, give it a good yank straight out. I already took it off. The second thing is make sure your shifter is in neutral. I mean, we're doing, battery's probably off, so I had to reconnect the battery to get it out of park. Once you do that, you can grab this guy back here. There's no screws in this first portion. And you just pull it straight up. And like so, you've got the top part removed. Next is a screw here and a screw here, and then two in the back to get the whole part, the whole center section. All right, so there's a couple plugs that are under the seat here. So you gotta get those out first. And then if you have any extra wiring that you added yourself, and then you gotta make sure you take out 1, 2, 3, 4. It's a Torx T27. And then pull the shifter up and then you can start to wiggle her out. it's gonna go up pretty tight. Over the shifter.
And just look, make sure you don't have any wires that are supposed to come out. They're supposed to be unplugged. And just like that, she's out. Here's a little thing I added. Cigarette lighter in the back and USB plugs in the back. Kind of makes it nice for passengers.
All right, so then we remove any little plugs that are in the shifter. And then we can remove the four bolts that are in it. And then it is time that we can actually remove the shifter wires. I'm going to remove the actual shifter, or the shift cables. There's a little tiny, for the, I think this is the lockout, brake lockout, or some safety switch. There's a little lever you pull on the side, and you lift the whole thing straight up. Same with the actual plug. Luckily, this one you can pull it out on this side, the left side of it. You pull it out, and you push it right up. Get the actual shifter disconnected from the cable disconnect from the shifter and just pry sideways on it. Pops right off.
And then here's where the shifter goes through under the tub. And of course this little rubber gasket helps. And you should be able to push the whole cable through.
So then once I get the bracket and the actual controller, the shifter will essentially mount somewhere right in here. This will go over it like so. And then what I plan on doing is just making a boot that'll just clean all this off. Not doing any extra plastic, no nothing. Just literally a leather boot. I'll show an example of what I did in my BMW for that. So. Yep. Other than that, for now, just stay tuned for the next video and hopefully soon we'll be getting this transmission put in and getting everything buttoned up. But for now, thanks for watching.